Hi, this is Alan with Very Super Cool Tools, and I just want to show this tenoning jig that goes on the Very Super Cool T-square table saw fence on this extrusion. Now, I have this mounted on this big 40 by 120 millimeter, and in some ways it's actually kind of, overkill, but it would work just as well if you mounted that traveling assembly onto one of the 40 by 80s. There's no problem. In some ways, this is actually kind of trouble having it up this tall. So if you are, it can work either way. That's all I'm trying to say. So here is the bearings. This is a THK bearing rail right here. This is what it looks like. Just the nude bearing or the nude rail. And this is all metric. This is made in Japan, and then the other one that we have access is the Taiwanese brand Hainan. And you're always welcome to come up with your own source for these kind of things too. But these are incredible systems. These are used in every type of industrial application, from computer controlled machines to just anything you can think of. These kind of precision rails and bearings are used. But this accepts a 5 millimeter cap head screw. That's what goes down in here like this. So even a quarter 20 won't fit. It's not right. The cap is too big. So even though the 6 millimeter fits through here, it won't go down in there. This will give you just a little bit of jiggle and play down here. Okay, so let me tell you what I've got going on here. So, I just have this short section of extrusion out so I can use it as to demonstrate. So this is just a piece of mild steel flat bar, and I have a big, let me say this right now, I have a big debt of thanks to say to my good friend August Lehman from Guide to Woodworking, Guide to Machining. He has been an incredible source for these THK bearing rails and these aluminum extrusions. And this setup is actually partially his build. He started with this, but it didn't work out for what he wanted to use, so he gave it to me. And then I modified it some more to make it work on my setup. So, I want to just, give August a big shout out, because he's always a... he's always an incredible resource for all kinds of machine and tool information. Okay, so what's happening here is you've got this piece of flat bar, and the flat bar is attached to the top of the aluminum extrusion, and you can see that it overhangs on the side a little bit. It's not, you don't want to have any interference off this face. And of course, it's attached via the T-nuts. So you've got your countersunk cap screws here that go down and find the T-nut, and then just pin this down. The actual bearing rail then is attached to the mild steel by first placing this on here, using a transfer punch to mark some holes, and then drilling and tapping the receivers here to then pin this to this. I'm actually going to take this apart today while I'm shooting this video. Not completely, but I got to make a little adjustment. I noticed a little bit of that this end has to get adjusted a little bit on the to make sure that it's running exactly parallel to the face. I don't know what happened. Maybe it was never that way, but I just looked at it with my real accurate mid tutorial ruler, place this on the face, and then looked at it in relationship to the bearing guide, and I'm off about half a millimeter. So I'm just going to rack it and adjust it, and then retighten everything down. But that'll give me a good reason to kind of break this guy apart and show you how it works. So let me just get at it. So the first thing I'm going to do is just take off this. So let me move. Before I get going on that, I'll move the camera around here and let you see what this backside looks like. So when I made this this part, I took a piece of aluminum plate and I drilled as accurately a pattern as I could to mate up with the bearings on the the holes, the four holes on the top of each of the bearings that you'll see here in a second. I left it here because I didn't know what I may want to attach to this at some point. There's all kinds of fixtures that I could you know, put on this. I could actually have another setup that sat out here, and you know, with this, all I have to do, you probably saw me do this, all I have to do is take the four bolts out of the bottom of this, and I can flip this end for end. So the variations and the combinations that you can create with this are, you know, pretty unbelievable. And it kind of gives me a handhold right here. But I didn't want to cut this off prematurely because at some point there may be some crazy fixture or contraption that I want to add to this. So that's the only reason this is out here, just because, you know, it could have a future use. So this is just my sacrificial fence here. And, you know, any combination of things can be done with this. I mean, this could be mounted at an angle. This could be a wedge material. Anything under the sun that you can dream up for the specific operation that you're wanting to work on is possible. That's what the beauty of these tracks gives you. And see that quickly, now I'm off. Okay, I think maybe this is a better view. So now that I've got the fence off of it, that my vertical fence, now I've got two hex bolts that are drilled through the bottom of the plate that come up and find T-nuts in here. So let me reach in here and see if I can't get these off without getting dyslexia in the process. Well, that's the wrong way. The beauty of using these T-nuts is that the bolt never has to come completely out to make it work. You know, all you have to do is just basically loosen it up and then the system will slide off, as you can see here. So there's the first major component removed. Okay, so with just my short piece of extrusion removed now you can see this is just the aluminum deck that I use to pin the two bearings together. Now I use two bearings because that's what my friend August gave me with this setup. I am 100, 200, 300% sure that you could make this same setup with one bearing and be absolutely confident, because these bearings have zero, no jiggle or slop in them. And for woodworking, what we're doing, they're more than adequate. You know, two bearings, of course, you're spreading this out more over this linear thing. Of course, it would have to be even a little bit more solid, but you know, if you didn't want to spend the money on a second bearing to try this system out, you could always buy one bearing and come back in with a second one later. And, you know, just as simple as modifying a plate here and you'd be set to go. And these are metric screws because these thread straight into the top of the bearing, and that's a metric receiver on those. That's metric threads on the top. What is this? That's a, these are 6 millimeters. That's what these are, 6 millimeter metric threads that go down into here. But so now here you can see the bearings are, these are free. And you can just see, you know, how incredible they are. They have these grease fittings. One thing you want to be very, very careful about, don't put grease in these unless the bearing is on the rail. That's really, really important because the tolerances are so tight on this that you put grease in here with it off the rail and the bearings will come out. So you don't want to put grease in until you've got this seated on the rail, so it's going to hold the bearings in place. And this is just a stopper here that I have at the end just to keep from, you know, pulling this whole system off. Well, I think this will give you a really good idea now how I'm going to make this adjustment. So I've got all these guys loosened up, and I've got the rail on the top loosened up a little bit too, because I think The cap screws were coming down here and biting into the top of the aluminum and not letting it move freely, so I kind of backed these off. And I can't detect any jiggle in the relationship between this and the flat bar, but I can move this flat bar, not so much at this end, so this is going to be my adjustment end over here. And I'm just going to use my good Mittatoyo ruler, and I'm going to set this distance here off this this face, and then put a light tight on this, and then go down and just tweak it down there. Can't do any better than that. I mean, that's just dead on.